a beautiful morning. We have had some great weather here in Springfield, Illinois at the Palomino World Show.
It's actually the 40th anniversary of the Palomino Horse Breeders of America hosting a world show. It actually started in Indianapolis, moved to Tulsa, then Tunica, and now in Springfield here. So if you love the beautiful Palomino horse and Palomino bred horse, and you love a family type atmosphere, you've got a little bit of a competitive edge, you're not gonna wanna miss this show.
Hello everyone, I'm Merle Arbo.
And I'm Susie Arbo, and welcome to Better Horses.
The Palomino Horse Breeders of America is proud to have Tony Burris, a tri-chairman of the World Show. We had a chance to visit with Tony as he provides insights in preserving the PHBA World Show and the beautiful Palomino and Palomino bred horses.
Introducing professional horseman Justin Brown from Cresson, Texas. Justin's dedication to the equine industry has proven successful as a career, but incorporates his entire family in providing an expert and skilled practice for his clients and the horses.
Better Horses welcomes Charlie Pollard, horse show announcer from Oklahoma. Charlie takes pride in making horse shows run smoothly and efficiently. He keeps the excitement high and is truly a talent.
Next up, we have Tri-Chair Marianne Felice of the PHBA World Show. She not only manages the check-in gate, but also serves as an equipment judge. Her smile and passion for PHBA is contagious. If you love horses as much as we do, you're not going to want to miss this horse show.
If you aren't already following Better Horses on social media, look us up and give us a like.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
American Animal Health has what we call an unconditional commitment. Our team members have spent countless hours relocating horses, finding horses, and helping those in need. Going and helping in the California wildfires. One of the passions we have as a team is not only helping horses, but helping people. And when we can put the two together, that really lights us up. It's just who we are.
For over 150 years, we've been working towards today. Because somewhere, today is somebody's first. Today's the first time she beat Dad, a day he'll never live down. For some, it's the first time on the range. And for others, the first tournament of the year. No matter what today is, we'll be ready. Because our legacy was founded on being there for your first. And we'll be there for your last. Winchester, the American legend.
Welcome back. We are here at the 40th anniversary of the World Show in Springfield, Illinois, and I am joined with Mr. Tony Burris, and he is what is called a tri-chair of the World Show. So Tony, can you share a little bit about what that's like?
Sure. I'm one of three, Terry Green, myself, and Marianne Felix. And what we do is we try to organize and put on this world show for PHBA.
And do you guys each have specific roles that you play in the tri-chair?
We sure do. Of course, Terry is the general manager. She runs the office and has a staff that helps her. I personally run the show arena, and I have we're very blessed to have the staff that we have to help us and make this thing work. Yes. Marianne Felix herself, she has her own staff, and they are in charge of checking in the horses and applying the rules and making sure everyone's legal when they come in.
Absolutely, and you guys work so well together, and the show is amazing. So thank you for what you do.
Well, we're always trying to improve, but thank you.
And Tony, we always want to send a very special thank you to Terry and Tammy Bradshaw. They have done so much for the Palomino breed, and they kicked in a lot of money again and beautiful buckles for our amateur halter classes.
Yes, ma'am, they certainly have. And with their support, it has breathed a new breath of life back into the halter of the Palomino horse. Of course, they exclude themselves from the monies, but it picks right up wherever in the placings, and exhibitors are, they're very blessed to have what the Bradshaws have done for the PHBA.
Absolutely. Our numbers are great in the halter, and people are having fun with it, so we're blessed.
They've given it a brand new, a breath of fresh air. That's what they've done. Participation is increasing each World Show, and just can't say enough how much we appreciate what the Bradshaws do for us.
Absolutely. And there was something else that was really fun that happened this year. It was the Showmanship Shootout.
At the Showmanship Shootout. It was an amazing event, well represented, well attended from the entries as well as the crowd. They had one exhibitor that was dressed in the number 12 uniform and, you know, actually threw a spiral football just like Terry used to do. So I think that impressed a lot of people.
It did, and you just never knew what was going to come in next, and it was all choreographed to music, and people were in costumes, and it was just to put the fun back into showing.
And I will reiterate that. You never knew what was coming through the gate next.
We had so much fun the other night. We had an exhibitor party, a big block party, and we had some live music, and we had really good food. What did you think about all that?
I thought it was great. The street was packed. We had good music, and the thought that I had at that time in North Carolina where I live, it's a big, big thing. It's called Merle Fest. And I wanted to say that my first thought was we should name that portion of it Merle Fest. So you guys can work that out, and I think that would be appropriate.
I love that. I love it because some of our live music was from Merle Arbo and Brady Horn and Wyatt Oryk sang. And so I think we could get even some more people going and call it a big Merle Fest. Good idea, Tony.
I think you sure could.
All right. Well, we like to have a lot of fun, as you can see here at the Palomino World. So sometime you need to come here and join us.
Please do.
Horse lovers, there's more better horses coming your way from Springfield, Illinois, from the Palomino Horse Breeders of America World Show.
Discover the elegance, beauty, and untamed spirit of the Palomino horse. Join the Palomino Horse Breeders of America and become part of a great horse community, passionate about their family, friends, and horses. Whether you're a longtime breeder, an accomplished equestrian, or simply someone captivated by their golden beauty, you'll find a welcoming family here, ready to share their knowledge and encourage you along your journey. With PHBA, you'll create lasting bonds with these beautiful creatures, create lasting memories, and be a part of a family that loves the Golden Palomino horses and the Palomino bred horses that enhance our breed even more. Join the Palomino Horse Breeders of America today. Find a show near you and unlock a golden world of opportunities. Visit our website at www.palominohba.com. Follow us on social media or call us at 918-438-1234 to become part of the Golden family. Palomino Horse Breeders of America, where passion and beauty unite.
For over 150 years, we've been working towards today. Because somewhere, today is somebody's first. Today's the first time she beat Dad, a day he'll never live down. For some, it's the first time on the range. And for others, the first tournament of the year. No matter what today is, we'll be ready. Because our legacy was founded on being there for your first and will be there for your last. Winchester, the American legend.
Here's
Welcome back to Better Horses. We're here at the Palomino World Show in the beautiful facility here at Springfield, Illinois. And I'm here with my good friend, Justin Brown. Justin, tell us a little bit about you and what you do.
I've been training horses my whole life and thoroughly enjoy it. And I enjoy the Palomino shows and being here at the World Show this year. And all the camaraderie, the friends, the family organization around here, and it just gives you that good family feel that anybody would enjoy being around.
And I know you brought a lot of horses and you show a lot of different events. What's a piece of advice if somebody's at home, you know, thinking about they want to be here, what would you tell them? Like if our viewers at home are saying, hey, that looks like an event I'd like to be at next year, what would you tell them?
I would tell them, you know, check with a local trainer, get lessons, or help get the guidance to get the right horse to be able to come here and have the flow of how to come show here at this event.
So Justin, we're here at this facility, and this venue is kind of unique to the horse show world. Tell us why you think this is different than most of the facilities we show horses at.
I'll tell you, I've shown at a lot of facilities all over the U.S., and I can say the first time I came here in 2020, the first year the Palomino World Show has been held here, it just feels like a home away from home. It's like pretty much every trainer has like their own barn, their own facility here, where when it's cold at night, you can shut all the doors, you can shut all the windows, you can turn the lights and the fans off at night and know that it feels that cozy feeling, that the stalls are safe, big sized, and it's just but everyone's close together, but they have individual space where we're not all on top of each other.
That's right. That's great. And it's a really neat place. If you haven't been here, you need to come out at least to watch, to check it out. We've been really very fortunate. We've had great weather here. I mean, the whole week.
Oh, I tell you, you can't beat it when the high for the entire time we've been here is like 84. And I thoroughly enjoyed that the lows have been in the upper 50s, lower 60s.
It's been some really great mornings here. You know, one thing, and you mentioned it, you've been here since 2020, and I think a lot of our viewers would like to know, what was your first experience like at a big horse show, at a world show? Can you tell us something about that?
It's kind of like that awe moment where you look around, you see maybe people you idolize, maybe people you've seen, and you're just thinking, am I going to embarrass myself? Am I going to run into someone in the warm-up pen? But I've noticed that from the start in the Palomino organization, everybody is very nice, very courteous. We'll say, excuse me, can I help you? We'll help you get to your class if you're running behind, or loan you fake tail, ribbon supplies, anything you need.
Hey, thanks so much for being here on the show with us here in Springfield, Illinois at the Palomino World Show.
Thank you, Merle, for having me here. This is Justin Brown from Burleson, Texas. Thank you for watching Better Horses.
Cowboys and cowgirls, don't go anywhere. We have more Better Horses coming your way.
We're here for the hardworking, the resilient. We're for the people who measure their days by what needs to get done, not by hours. Where kids learn responsibility at a young age and generations work side by side. Where work doesn't pause for holidays or bad weather. It just gets harder. Where value and hard work means more than the clothes you wear. We're Kleinschmidt's Western Store, Higginsville, Missouri.
It's time to go with United Mosquito and Fly Control's premier fly system for fly control in your barn, providing relief for horses from the stress of fighting flies, and also makes a barn more pleasant for everyone in the barn. Easy, effective, and safe. With United Mosquito and Fly Control, we provide a full service. You as the barn owner don't have to do anything. We go everywhere and take care of everything with our friendly, fast service. Call today at 913-558-3814 or email Paul at unitedmosquito.com.
1956, the Pinto Horse Association of America was formed to welcome all types of equines and maintain their show records and pedigrees. PTHA currently has over 88,000 members with 157,000 registered Pintos. There are currently three separate registries: the Color Registry, the Solid Registry, and the Long Ear Registry. We welcome all levels of competition within a family-friendly environment. Become a member, register, and add value to your horse. For more information, check out the website, pintoworld.com.
My name's Charlie Pollard. I am from Ooliga, Oklahoma. I've been an announcer for the last 10 years. My daughter showed horses for 4-H in Claremore, Oklahoma. The announcer that they were supposed to have got sick and was not able to show up. So they just asked all the dads, does anybody have a problem being embarrassed talking on the microphone? I just jumped in and said, here, I'll do it, and just volunteered. And Daryl Bilkey, the president of the Pinto Horse Association, happened to be our judge that day and liked the way my voice sounded and liked the way that I did things. So he flipped me his card and said, here, I can keep you busy. I do the Palominos. I do the ABRA, which is the Buckskin Registry. I do the Pinto Horse Association and the Paint Horse Association. The hardest thing about my job that most people would not realize is the multitasking that we have to do. Not only are we trying to keep up with the class that we're in, but we need to be a class ahead, making sure that our exhibitors are ready to come into the arena, that this class is being placed and the judges' cards are being read in the proper manner, all the while keeping the exhibitors going, keeping the crowd entertained, keeping everybody happy and in a good mood and not getting people upset. So I would say that the biggest part is multitasking. I think what makes the Palomino World Championship Show set apart from all the rest of them is not only the atmosphere that you get here with the Coliseum and the age of it and just the everything that comes along with it, but the Palomino horse people are just so close-knit and such a good family and such good friends, and they are always cheering each other on and always trying to help each other out, whether they're winning, losing, or not even exhibiting, but still there to be able to help and support.
And I'm from Detroit Lakes, Minnesota.
And I'm Megan Carlson from Detroit Lakes, Minnesota.
And we welcome everybody to come join us at the Palomino World Show.
This is our fourth year here at the PHBA World Show, showing in all the game events, along with halter, pleasure, and even in PHBA bred.
We have a great time here. This is the most wonderful place and the most family-friendly horse show atmosphere I've ever shown in.
Horse lovers, there's more better horses coming your way from Springfield, Illinois, from the Palomino Horse Breeders of America World Show.
Here's to the unbreakable spirit of today's ranchers. For all those running cow-calf operations, the American International Charolais Association is dedicated to strengthening your herd with the Charolais breed. The Charolais Advantage delivers more pounds for more profit. Getting Charolais genetics into commercial herds is the heart of a successful cattle operation. White hides bring an inherited benefit to commercial herds, providing advantages of growth and feedlot efficiency. It's white gold. For more information, go to charoletusa.com.
For 150 years, we've been working towards today. Because somewhere, today is somebody's first. Today's the first time she beat Dad, a day he'll never live down. For some, it's the first time on the range. And for others, the first tournament of the year. No matter what today is, we'll be ready. Because our legacy was founded on being there for your first. And we'll be there for your last. Winchester, the American legend.
Hi, I'm Marianne Felix. We're in Springfield, Illinois at the Palomino World Championship Show, and this is the 40th year. And I am an equipment judge that checks in the horses before they go into the Coliseum to show. Our equipment judges have to check all the equipment and attire for each exhibitor so that they have the proper attire and equipment before they show into the Coliseum. When we check our equipment, we have to drop the bridles and check the bits, the saddles, the attire that they are wearing, making sure they have the proper attire, and all of the chains, make sure everything is correct on all of the equipment. Make sure our back numbers are the what belongs to each exhibitor. We have to make sure that they have an ID stamp on their number. This makes sure that they're legal before going into the horse show pen. And that's what we do back here at the back gate. Before they go into the Coliseum, they have to all be checked, every single one.
I'm Jaden Chain. I'm from Pond Creek, Oklahoma. My main job here is helping book down there at the back gate, getting people checked in, helping fall up here. Then I have a little bit different setup this year, so people got to cross the street, and kind of in charge of helping keep everybody safe, keeping traffic down while we got classes going in, people coming in and out, and make sure everybody's staying safe and getting checked into their classes, and make sure everybody's staying hydrated up here in the seat. I think our biggest challenge we've had this year has been there's a lot of construction going on, and there's a lot of new people, and we've been trying to all kind of grow together, and it's turned out to be a pretty good show, and we've had some great people, great exhibitors, great staff, and we've just kind of all been a learning curve this year.
Hello, I'm Ron Hack, and we're here at the Illinois State Fair for the Palomino World. What I do here is try to prepare the ring as good as I can to make softening, cushioning for the horses. But each ring is different from the Coliseum to the warm-up rings around. The dirt can be a little dry or a little wet. And you got to work whichever it goes for. Either raise it up or lower it down to keep the moisture in and keep it sealed up to where it's got a lot of cushioning. Well, in the one ring we got a lot of hard clay in there. They use it for motorcycles and stuff during the winter. It's a little tougher to get worked up, but it's good for barrel racing and mounted shooting and stuff like that. The other ring here, the 13 barn, it's got some sawdust in it, but it's got hard clay, and it's a little bit different how you got to work it up. It can work up real fine or it can work up real hard. It just depends on how much water you put in it and everything. The Coliseum is altogether different. We put different footing in that one because we use it for the saddlebred shows a lot here. The saddlebreds, they like about 3 or 4 inches of cushioning but a hard base underneath. So when they step on it, it just kind of cushions and comes back up just a little bit. And they like it real fluffy and everything on that part. Barrel racers, they want it deep, but they want it to where you can almost make a ball with it. And so is my mounted shooters. The Palomino horses, they like it more, a good base underneath, but they like a lot of cushioning on it. For like 2 to 3 inches cushioning on them for their horses, so it makes it easier on their legs. They don't have no problems with that and everything. Yeah, one thing I like about most of the jobs that I do for all the shows I do is the people. If I make it good for them, they love it and they come back and bring more people to it, the show and everything. But most of the people, they enjoy it, having fun here. I'm Ron Hack here at the Palomino World in Springfield, Illinois. Thanks for watching Better Horses.
Hey, thank you for watching Better Horses. And if you've missed any of our shows, check us out at betterhorses.com where you can see all our episodes.
You can also follow us on Facebook or listen to any of our podcasts right from your mobile device.
And don't forget our newspaper coming out 5 times a year.
You're gonna love it.